Welcome back to Hello Nigeria. We have TG Banks with us, and of course Esther Adesewankwa and yours truly. Hello guys.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you? How's the weekend?
You're popping, no?
I'm popping.
Weekend was
popping
so,
like popcorn. Shout out to the team behind the camera. Special shout out to all of you. Thank you so much.
I hope I can
for this pop.
Eh? Am I popping?
You're popping. You're popping. How's your weekend?
I don't know, it's mixed. I had a wedding to MC in Badagry.
You're MCing wedding now?
How many years?
Brother.
In Badagry, and that place is far. While I was coming back, I packed their sand. They didn't pay me so well, I might not go there again. That place is far. And the caterer was a bad cook.
Hey,
wow. They should call her Catherine.
Wow.
You know, I've seen white rice inside jollof rice. No.
Wow. This uncle is so much mean.
They pay me.
How was your own weekend?
My weekend was good, but it was stressful.
Stressful. Did you work?
Yes, I did.
Oh, sorry. My weekend was a turn-up weekend. I spent my weekend going out every day to one restaurant or the other. Shout out. It's good to have good friends in this life. Shout out to Ayo and Jennifer. Yeah. That's such a wonderful
sauce so that was boiling on the table.
No. It's fish and oyster sauce.
Chinese.
We're not looking at Chinese food today. We're not looking at fish and oyster sauce. We're celebrating a Nigerian who has gone to America and absolutely made us proud. Kamaru Usman, also known as the Nigerian Nightmare, born in Auchi, Edo State, left Nigeria at the age of 8 and migrated with his family to America. He's gone ahead to win the UFC championship. And of course, Nigeria, as usual, is so excited.
We are claiming it.
So he basically won. He recounted his ordeal in Nigeria. He expressed how he remembers when he was 7. Yeah. And the long miles he used to walk to go fetch water, and how he lived with his grandmother, and how when he recounts these experiences to his mom is still shocked that he can remember all of these.
At 7, he should remember it. It's so similar to Anthony Joshua's story, where he grew up in Sagamo, and he told the world that what molded him to be a world champion was when he was in boarding school in Nigeria, and when people were always, the seniors were always bullying him. That shaped him up to be the kind of man he is today. So that tells you something different and unique about Nigeria. Maybe I'll have to go through that so that I can become a world champion.
Are you kidding me?
I don't know what I'm going to go through. Kamaru is a legend now. We are all celebrating him. It's from my state actually.
Edo State.
Edo State. It's actually from my state, and his village is not just adjacent.
It's okay, we understand.
We can claim, Sha.
From Owa to Auchi now, his now village is
no,
close to.
It's just like there's a house in between. Let's just leave the house.
But let's really specially celebrate, the senior special advisor to the president on foreign affairs, Abike Dabiri Erewa. Exactly. Well, that was a much of a tongue twister. Abike Dabiri Erewa has congratulated him for making Nigeria, and not just Nigeria, the continent proud. Now, she said, and he quoted, apparently, there was a statement accredited to him where he said, "Nigeria, I have told them we will do it. I told them we never fail, and we have done it today." Now, he won the United Ultimate Fighting Championship.
Yeah, UFC. UFC is a mixed martial art. It's unique. It is what has taken the shine out of wrestling right now. Growing up, we used to be so freaky wrestling until we heard stories about it, and I don't want to go into
when did you lose
WWF.
And when I heard it's more of acting and all that, then I started remembering Okogan coming in and we always went out like so. I was a moment then.
Well, the funny thing, even with wrestling, for the longest time, I loved wrestling. In fact, wrestling was my family sport up to my grandmother. Oh, my lovely grandmother, may her soul rest in peace. She'd watch wrestling and be like, "Why is that one beating him? He's such a wicked person." Stop it, all this she's saying in Igbo. But it was a family sport we grew up to watch. I didn't know of this one.
UFC.
I didn't know much about UFC. So UFC is mixed martial arts. You know, taekwondo and all the
boxing,
lightweight,
jiu-jitsu. I've watched the other one.
If they allow them, they will shoot bottle. You know, I looked at UFC. I find it hard to watch UFC, unfortunately, because it's so brutal.
Really
physical, fight with everything, their legs, their hand, boxing, taekwondo. It's mixed martial art. And for a Nigerian of that kind to win it, it's a big deal. Because the guy he fought against, Tyron happened to be the champion for a long time in that category, the welterweight category. Now he has defeated him, now he's the champion. Mm-hmm. And I hope he can hold that belt for a long time to come. Knowing that he's a Nigerian gives us another prize, something to celebrate. We've not been celebrating for a while now. We've been complaining. And now we have something to celebrate. We have Anthony Joshua in the heavyweight boxing category.
And we are rooting for him to go and deal with
June 1, yeah.
Exactly.
The other guy said he would defeat him in the seventh round. And so Joshua said he's a small boy, so I should be there. Let's see how it goes.
All right, people, we're still going to continue this discussion, but let's throw to the video of Kamaru Usman concerning the UFC.
And that is the video of 31-year-old Kamaru Usman after winning the UFC.
Yeah, welterweight.
Very, very impressive. We're seeing lots of Nigerians who are outside the country making us proud. You know, we have him, we have Anthony Joshua, we have Divine Okorodudu, the man that we popularly know as I Never Expected
It.
No, we have so many young Nigerians doing amazing outside. Yeah. But the question is, if they were left in Nigeria, if they stayed back in Nigeria, would they have these opportunities and would they be celebrated this much?
It depends. If you look at athletics, for example, we should be doing better than what we're doing right now. Right from time, we see a lot of Nigerian international athletes leave Nigeria to go outside. Like, I can't remember this guy's name, Francis Obikwelu. He left Nigeria, was running for Nigeria 100 meters, 200 meters. He left and he went to Portugal. He was the first set of guys that left Nigeria and opened people's eyes that you can actually go and get something better than what we're offering. But when it comes to UFC, UFC is not a Nigerian thing. It's not an African thing. So you need to go out there to explore.
Beyond UFC, we have some traditional sports that we can, you know, engage in. Why don't we promote our traditional sports? We have, you know, the, I don't know, I can't remember a lot of their names, but, you know, the arm wrestling. There's some of our traditional sports. And when you go to the village, even you see the village wrestling and all that, why can't we promote it and accept it amongst ourselves
first,
so that it becomes a national thing that we can look up to. And then we can then make it, we can export it.
The truth is, if you look at the sports ministry in itself, a country is the sports industry or the ministry of a country is a reflection of the country itself most times. How well your country is faring, it will show in your sport, it will show in your security, it will show in your economics, it will show in your economy as a whole. So our sport is like this because the country is like this. It is just what it is. We can't change it until Nigeria starts to step up.
Are you sure it's that way? Because I remember the time Chioma Adjumwa actually had to go to China to train before actually winning the medal that she won at the Olympics there. Yeah. Now, she said it was self-sponsored.
What year was that? That was 1996.
Of course.
Do you remember Nigeria in 1996? We were doing better than what we're doing now.
But she was still self-sponsored.
Because things were better. We had people that were so much interested in sports and not unlike now.
Now, I think we do have an increased interest in sports, but unfortunately, just as we
don't
see,
have a structure.
We're seeing economic migration. So what we have is people are fleeing because they want a better life. It's the same thing that's happening in the sporting world.
Yeah.
They understand that there's these talents that we have here, but they find that they can sell their talents or run for another country. I mean, we had an athlete on the show once. Mm. Yeah. She didn't run for Nigeria. She ran for her country, the country where she migrated to, or the country where she was born. Mm. And she said when it got to time for her to run, they asked her, which country do you want to run for? Do you want to run for Nigeria or do you want to run for our country? Yeah. And she said, man, at the end of the day, Nigeria had not invested as much in her as her other country did. Yeah. And she writes for her other... She ran for our other country. So we will continue seeing things like this if we don't make our economy better so that our young people don't stop running out
of the country. We don't take sports seriously. What we do here is Olympics is every four years. After 1 year, you see everything is collapsed. Then once it's like 2 months, 3 months to the Olympics, where you see other countries, other developed climes preparing for Olympics 10 years ahead, 5 years ahead. They know a boy of 14 is going to represent them in the next 6-7 years.
He's already being trained.
But Nigeria, just 2 months, 3 months, they bring everybody to the game.
How is it that thing?
Bad preparation,
everything.
Bad facilities. So it's beyond just sport. You see a lot of Nigerians in the IT world running to Canada, running to Germany to do other stuff.
No, aside from facilities, I want to actually chip in that sometimes they're saying, even if something happens to them while they're doing this patriotic act, you know, there's no insurance.
No proper insurance.
I remember what happened to Victor Anichebe until today.
Nice.
He's still, you know,
Let's not even look at insurance. We have people that will go and play. Time for them to pay them their allowances, so, you know, their stipends. Nothing of the sort. Yeah. They're busy, you know, hanging out of hotels, waiting for their hotel bills. Many times we've seen our players, our football players, shamelessly, you know, we've seen them being treated wrongfully. They're not being paid as much as they should be.
It happened with Mikel Obi in the last Olympic.
I think he was the one that ended up sponsoring and paying bills.
And a Japanese came from
because he
was impressed with the way Nigerians came in a few days or few hours to their first game and they won. So he had to pay off their allowances and
all that,
which was
Cup.
Quite embarrassing. But they had to accept it. Mikel too had to pay some guys. And
then members of the house still said it was insulting. How nice.
Okay, so we celebrate Kamaru, we celebrate every other Nigerian that is making us proud within and outside the country. And we're hoping that things will change in Nigeria, that the sporting industry will become something that people around the world will look forward to, will appreciate, and that we don't get to see our young people migrating, running out of the country.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.